Good morning, everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Nick Hick, and Frozen 2, and No Time to Die fans, so that's one now. And this is going to be one of the longest video I ever did, and I know I say it like a silver time, but it's true. But if you guys have a problem with my runtime, just don't watch my video, because my video is a bit longer, just like the Michael Jackson music videos and like the Lord of the Rings trilogies. Yeah, I'm probably those two things all longest thing that you ever did in your life. But my video was longer, just like the Michael Jackson music videos. So all the Michael Jackson music videos is a little longer. That is one of the most longest music videos I ever seen in my life. And so, hey guys, so do you remember, and I did my best movie from every year I was alive? Yeah, that video was god-awful. That video was awful. I think I'm going to do it today. So yeah, guys, honestly, I'm not going to do it today. So I'm probably going to keep it for the fun memory. So that video was god-awful. Did not age well. It's outdated. So, yeah. And so, hey guys, I got some couple live-action movies. So if you guys have a problem with that, just don't watch it, because let's get started, shall we? And so, hey guys, so today's video, I'm going to tell you my, today's video is about the best movie from every year I was alive. These are the movie, all huge, and the number one best movie of 2001 all the way to 2022. The Lord of the Rings, Freshman of the Ring, and all the way to Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. And so, hey guys, no dishonor to mention, because this is going to be the huge video. The reason why I'm doing the best movie first, then my worst movie, because if I do my worst movie first, Frozen will have a problem with this. So doing two Elsa's on the thumbnail, hey, let's do the video first. So, yeah. And so, hey guys, not enough talking. Let's go to the call from back in the future, go all the way to 2001, and all the way to now. Anyway, guys, let's get started, shall we? Back in 2001. Well, originally Shrek is my favorite movie of 2001, but every time I think about the movie, and a lot of time, it deserves it. Alright. In the 2001 movie called The Lord of the Rings, The Freshman of the Ring. This movie is a great start to the Lord of the Rings trilogy, and this movie is honestly one of the best trilogy in the history of film. The story is really original. The action is so unforgettable. It's a really awesome action. And the climax, this is honestly one of the second best climax I've ever seen for the Lord of the Rings trilogies. And that Gandalf say, "You shall not pass," that line is legendary, and that actor who the voice Gandalf, he's a really awesome actor. He played by the same actor. He was an X-Men. So yeah. And so, hey guys, if you haven't seen the movie, I highly recommend you check it out. And I know Freeman would not like The Lord of the Rings because she told me The Lord of the Rings is not her cup of tea. So I can't respect that. And so, hey guys, so that's why The Lord of the Rings, The Freshman of the Ring is honestly one of the best movie of 2001. It's way better than Freddy Got Fingers. I don't want to talk about that trash. And so, hey guys, I want to say one more thing. You shall not pass. Now, let's go all the way to 2002. And I know Redabot keeps saying it's 2001 have bullcrap. It's say 2001. It's say 2002. Anyway, guys. One of the best movies of 2002. It has to be Spirits Away. This movie is honestly one of my favorite anime movie I have ever seen in my life. Anime. This movie made me love anime. This is the main reason why I'm wearing this Hunter x Hunter shirt my mom got me at Hot Topic. Yeah, this movie is a really awesome anime movie. The story is so original. The character is unforgettable. And the animation. This is honestly one of the best animation I ever seen for an anime movie. And I know it's from Walt Disney Studio Present in a Studio Crazy film. But honestly, that studio who made this. And thank you, Disney, for buying this studio. And now this studio left for Disney because they got copyright. So I'm probably that studio moved to HBO Max. So I really hope Spirits Away and all the Studio Grizzly, it will be on Disney Plus. Like, come on, it's a Walt Disney Studio Present. So yeah. And so, hey guys, and that's why Spirits Away is honestly one of the best movies of 2002. Alright, let's go back into 2003. So I'm probably you guys going to say Finding Nemo is one of your best movie of 2003. But honestly, this is honestly one of the longest movie I have ever seen for the Mighty Earth Saga. And Peter Jackson, please, I will hire you to direct my movies. Because Peter Jackson is a really awesome, is a really awesome director. We can't forget Peter Jackson, his directing style. Like The Lord of the Rings, like The Hobbit, The King Kong, and etc. All these great movies he directed. I don't have any worst movie he ever directed, but he is perfect. So hey guys, one of the best movies of 2003, it had to be The Lord of the Rings, Return of the King. This movie, I said a lot. I said a lot in my review, I said a lot in my top 10 best movie of 2003, and this movie is way better than Dr. Seuss The Cat in the Hat 2003. Well, even 2003 has a more crappy movie, but honestly, thank God this movie saved 2003. And I gotta say, 2003 is honestly one of the top 5 best year for movies, so. But honestly, 2019 will always be the best movie from the year for made movies, so yeah. And so, hey guys, the story is so amazing. The character, they're all back for the action, and the action is so awesome. And the special effect, they deserve that winning, man. And The Lord of the Rings, Return of the King, this is honestly one of the best Oscar movie I have ever seen in my entire life. Reason why? Because this is the very first Lord of the Rings movie. Not one, not two, not three, but 11 Academy Award. They won for Best Director, Best Screenplay, Best Song, Best Original Score, Best Screenplay, Best Director, and including Best Picture. You hear me? Best Picture. This is the reason why this movie is legendary. This movie is honestly, is top deal what Zack Snyder just did in the Avengers Endgame. Added out one of the longest movie I have ever seen in my life. And thank God we have the Hobbit trilogy, which honestly is added one of the underrated trilogy from Peter Jackson. But sadly all the Hobbit movie will not be on the we won't be in the video, so yeah. And so hey guys, and that Into the West song, wow, that song is one of the best songs that The Lord of the Rings ever did. Because even Lord of the Rings like the action and adventure movie, but Into the West, love that song. I can't play that song because it's owned by Warner Bros. So yeah. And so hey guys, and this is honestly one of my second favorite Warner Bros. Movie I've ever seen in my life. And so that's why The Lord of the Rings, Return of the King is added out one of the best movie of 2003. Alright, get your suit up, get your incredible, get ready for action, and Sean BBS, if you're watching it, this is for you, pal. One of the best movies of 2004. It has to be The Incredible. We can't forget The Incredible. The Incredible is honestly one of the best what's that director's name again? I got a brain fart, oops. And so hey guys, and this movie is honestly one of the best animated movie of 2004. I know you're all gonna say Shrek 2 is one of your favorite movie from 2004, but every time I think of a movie, and a lot of time, I just rewatched Shrek 2, and it's a really awesome masterpiece, but this movie is way better. And so yeah, and this movie is a way better anime movie than the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. Well, even I like the movie, but that movie is not the best movie from Nickelodeon, but that movie has a few huge negatives. So yeah guys, the story is really original. The character is really awesome. My favorite character of this movie is had to be Elastigirl. She's honestly one of my favorite female character crush I have seen in 2004. The same thing with the human princess Fiona from Shrek 2. And Syndrome, this is honestly one of the best Pixar villains I have ever seen, because Syndrome is a really awesome villain, and I can't forget Syndrome. In the action, we never seen Pixar do this kind of action, and I know you saw every Pixar movie has some action, right? The upcoming Lightyear would be my favorite Pixar movie I've ever seen. Well, originally this movie was my favorite Pixar movie, but every time it's turning red, Luca, Soul, Onward, Lightyear, yeah. And sorry guys, and Mr. Incredible is a really awesome character. And Frozone is played by Samuel L. Jackson. Yep, the same actor with the voice of Nick Fury and Marcus Bank from Spyro for the Book of Saw. He's in this movie. And I'm probably Samuel L. Jackson really like to be in the Pixar movie. So yeah. And sorry guys, and that's why The Incredible is added as one of the best movies of 2004. Alright, let's get back to the darkest Star Wars. So do you remember in the prequel, they have Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clone? The Phantom Menace, I hate to say it, but the Phantom Menace is honestly one of the worst Star Wars movies I ever seen. Well, originally it was Rise of Skywalker, but I am leaving the hate bait from Rise of Skywalker. I think that movie is a huge bad movie, but honestly, it's not really a toxic movie that people think it is. And it's Attack of the Clone, oh my goodness, that movie is even worse than The Phantom Menace, so, yeah. And sorry guys, and after Revenge of the Sith, not bad, George Lucas, not bad at all. And this movie is a really awesome movie, and this is honestly one of the darkest Star Wars movie I have ever seen. We have never seen this kind of Star Wars movie be so dark, other than Revenge of the Sith. The story is so really awesome. The characters is so amazing. Obi-Wan Kenobi is a really awesome character. This is honestly one of the best Star Wars characters in the film. And Obi-Wan Kenobi's son, he's a really awesome character. And Darth Vader, he came back. He's a really awesome character. And the lightsaber. And honestly, one of the best scenes of this movie, it had to be the one of the poster with Obi-Wan Kenobi and fighting his son. Man, that is dark. You see the fires, all the kinds of stuff. We've never seen that kind of Star Wars movie have some fire in it, because all we see is a bunch of lightsabers and a bunch of special effects. But at least the Star Wars movie is a what difference. So people, I'm gonna give you a quick warning. So if you want to see this movie, you gotta be careful, because this movie is dark. It's amazing. It's awesome. I recommend you check it out. And this is honestly, what year just came out anyway? So, Star Wars Revenge of the Sith, this is honestly one of the best movies of 2005. Alright, let's go back to the Jane Bond. Alright, let's go back to the Dana Craig era. This is, in 2006. Sorry, guys. So, 2006, it was Dana Craig's big day. He is one of the favorite James Bond I have ever seen. So that's why I like No Time to Die, because of this movie, and Skyfall and Spectre and No Time to Die. But this is the very first Daniel Craig movies, but one of the best movies of 2006. It has to be Casino Royale. This movie is a really awesome James Bond movie. What a great start for the Daniel Craig Bond era, because this movie is really awesome. The villain, the story, direction, the production, acting, and Dana Craig, and Mrs. M, they're all really great character. And the villain, honestly, one of the best villain of 2006. This movie is a really awesome movie, and I highly recommend you check it out. Don't watch No Time to Die first, don't watch Skyfall first, don't watch Spectre first. If you watch that first, it will be really confusing. Just watch this first, and all the way, you can watch No Time to Die. Speaking of No Time to Die, I'm just going to rewatch No Time to Die rewatch No Time to Die for the fifth time, so yeah. And sorry guys, and that's why Casino Royale added one of the greatest start to the Daniel Craig Bond area. Added one of the best movie of 2006. Alright, let's get back to the fairy tale. We all love fairy tale. We love musical. We like Amy Adam. We like Minzy. But this movie, I cannot wait for the sequel. Just give a trailer to me now, Disney. I'm being impatient. Just give me the trailer. Yeah. And sorry guys, one of the best movie of 2007. It had to be Enchanted. This movie is the reason why I really love fairy tale. That's the main reason why I watched Shrek, Hoodwink 1, even I'm not a fan of that movie, because that movie is a huge overrated. But this movie is a really awesome fairy tale movie. The acting is so amazing. Like Amy Adam, she is honest. This is honestly one of the best performance I have ever seen. Next to what was Wayne and Zack Snyder Just Lead and Man of Steel and Batman v Superman and that terrible Joss Whedon, which honestly she was awful in the Joss Whedon version. I would have watched Zack Snyder Just Lead way better watching Joss Whedon. Joss Whedon. Yeah. And so, guys, and Nanny, this is honestly one of the best character of the entire movie because Minzy did a really good job as Nanny and in this movie. And the queen, and the evil queen holding the apple, and I forgot what his name is because I need to rewatch this movie on Disney Plus because, yep, folks, this movie's on Disney Plus. I recommend you watch this movie. If you haven't seen the movie, don't buy a DVD of it. Just get on your Disney Plus because it came out on Disney Plus Day. I recommend you watch it. So, yeah. And so, yeah, guys, and this is honestly one of the best working I have ever seen in 2007. And this movie is way better than Epic Movie. I hate the Epic Movie. This is honestly not the worst movie of 2007. That has to be Shrek the Third. But this movie is way better than Spider-Man 3, Epic Movie, and Shrek the Third. Honestly, one of the worst Shrek movies I've ever seen. You can check out my rant of it. It's pretty awesome. And this is on, and that's why Enchantress, aka Amy Adams, started again out of one of the best movies of 2007. If you haven't seen it, if you like fairy tale, musical, etc., I recommend you watch it. Hey, you up there right now. Alright, let's go back into 2008. 2008 was an okay year for movies because I know we had some crappy movies like the disaster movie, The Terror of the Dispolo, the one we get started talking about that trash. And I think that's probably it. But I know we got Snoop Dogg Millionaire. I kind of shame that this movie got snubbed for Best Picture, and all the Oscar category. But the only nominated that this movie got is Best Supporting Actor, Heath Ledger as the Joker, and one of the best movie of 2008. Added on one of the best written Batman movie I have ever seen, next to The Batman starring Robert Pattinson. It has to be The Dark Knight. Well, which means this movie was my favorite movie, favorite movie from The Batman, but honestly, one of the best Batman movies I ever seen. It has to be Robert Pattinson, The Batman. Well, the truth, 31, I kind of disagree of your opinion on the Batman because I don't have no problem that this movie, that The Batman is not Batfleck movie, Ben Affleck movie, so yeah. And so, hey guys, the story is really awesome. The character, so good. And Christian Bale as Batman, this is honestly one of the best Batman I've ever seen. Next to Robert Pattinson's Batman, and Ben Affleck's Batman from Zack Snyder's Justice League, The Tale of Joss Whedon, and most importantly, Batman v Superman. Honestly, well, originally I really did not like Batman v Superman, but every time I think about the movie, every time we watch Man of Steel and Zack Snyder Just a Date, I think Batman v Superman is not really a bad movie. I would have watched the director's cut way better watching the director's cut. I think the director's cut is awful, awful. And one of the best characters of the movie, it has to be Heath Ledger as Joker. Whoever think Heath Ledger as Joker, they deserve a Golden Globe reward. Wow. Heath Ledger as Joker is top there with Joker Phoenix. This is honestly one of my favorite Joker I have ever seen. And rest in peace to Heath Ledger, because I'm probably you all gonna say, Hey Nick, what happened to old good old Heath Ledger? Well, let me tell you something. After this movie came out, Heath Ledger was being his Joker and Will Wife. Well, you gotta be careful. So, if you get cast as Joker, you gotta be careful with it. Because I know what you guys die. Because this is the reason why he passed away. It's because he's trying to act like Joker. And his, and his Joker acting was getting on him. So, yeah, rest in peace to him. And this is kind of shame that, it's kind of shame that he was not in the Oscar ceremony. Yeah, you gotta be careful when you cast that kind of stuff, so yeah. And so, so if you go to your Hollywood, if you get cast from Joker, and etc., all the villain, you gotta be careful where you act, because it's the main reason why Heath Ledger died, because I don't want you guys to die doing too, you got cast for super characters, so yeah. Sorry, guys, and that's why The Dark Knight added one of the best Christopher Nolan movie I've ever seen. And this is honestly one of the best movie of 2008. Alright, even 2009 is honestly one of the worst years I ever experienced in my life. Yes. It's even worse than 2020. Oh, wait. Scratch that. It's not even worse than 2020. Alright, let's go back to 2009. This is honestly one of the second worst years I have ever experienced in my life. Like, come on, we have Michael Jackson pass away. We have a total movie like Dragon Ball Revolution. Who thinks it's a good idea? We have Conwine. We have Princess and the Frog. We have Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. We have those terrible movies. But after I watched The Hunter, The Hurt Walker, sign me in. Honestly, one of the best movies of 2009, it's had to be The Hurt Walker. This is honestly one of my favorite war movies I've ever seen. This movie is a really awesome war movie of the story of Hawkeye and Falcon going on to the war and do some explosions and stuff. And here's the one character, one of the best shots of this movie. It's had to be the one character running while the explosion. That is one of the most heartbreaking scene I ever seen in a war movie. The same thing with the Saving Private Ryan movies. Even I really enjoy Saving Private Ryan, but this movie is way better than Saving Private Ryan. And that's all I gotta say. So if you want to hit me a thought on this movie, hey, you can check out my review. Pretty awesome. I just uploaded it yesterday. And so that's why The Hurt Walker, this is honestly one of the best written war movie I've ever seen. And this is the main reason why this movie got a Wally reward. This movie won for Best Picture. No other war movie won for Best Picture. Yep, the same thing with The Lord of the Rings. This is honestly one of the legend war movie we ever gotten in no lifetime. I know that movie came out in 2009, but come on, just don't judge me. And sorry, guys, and I know this movie's rated R, but don't focus the darn rated R thing. Just watch it. Enjoy it. Don't be scared. Don't be just a fleety cat. Just watch it. It's pretty awesome. You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it, people. And that's why The Hurt Walker is honestly one of the best movies of 2009. And I really agree, my friend Buzz, because my friend Buzz really loved the movie. Even Mature loved the movie because they call it one of the fourth favorite movie of 2009 next to Zombieland, which honestly, I think Zombieland is not the best movie of 2009. Well, even I really enjoyed the movie, but I still have some few flaws about the movie, so yeah. And sorry, guys, and that's why The Hurt Walker is added up one of the best movies of 2009. And this is a great end to the 2000 decade. Let's go back to the 2010 decade. Added up one of the best decades we ever gotten. Alright, let's go back to 2010. Alright, back in 2010. I know 2010 has some water great stuff like that, like Tangled, Despicable Me, Toy Story 3, an exception, but no other movie would be the best movie of 2010. Added a one of the great start to the 2010 decade. This has to be the Christopher Nolan movie called Exception. This movie is a really fun action. This movie is a really awesome movie. One of the best scenes of this movie, it had to be the elevator fight scene when the building turning upside down and we know the characters fighting the villain of the movie. So yeah, and so you guys, look at all the characters we got. But come on, we got Tom Hardy, and we got the same actor he was in every Christopher Nolan movie, Michael Shannon. Yep, Michael Shannon. You know him as Phantom of Soul, which is honestly one of the weakest. I think Phantom of Soul from College Station, this is honestly one of the weakest performances I ever seen for Michael Shannon. Michael Shannon in this movie, he's a really awesome character of the movie. We can't forget Michael Shannon. Michael Shannon is a really a legend. I just heard a lot of people that he will retire, which honestly, he is not going to be retired. In news article, can you please stop saying he's going to be retired? It's stupid. It sounds stupid. I don't want him to retire. I want him to be every Christopher Nolan movie. We got the new upcoming Christopher Nolan movie. So how are you going to do a Christopher Nolan without any Michael Shannon cameos? Michael Shannon is the main reason why he made Christopher Nolan movie awesome. So yeah, and sorry guys, and that's why Exception, this is honestly one of the best movies of 2010. And in 2011, well, originally The Muppet was my favorite movie from 2011, but in 2020, after I watched this movie on on an Oscar week in 2021 on Netflix. This movie is honestly one of the best Marty movie I ever seen. And that movie is Higo. Every time I think about the movie, and a lot of times, this movie is a masterpiece. The story is really awesome. The character is so unforgettable. And Chloe Grace in the movie, she's a really adorable character of the movie. And the villain of this movie added one of the best villains of 2011. And I know a lot of people is going to say that Harry Potter Deathly Hallows Part 2 has added one of your favorite movie of 2011. Which honestly, I have not seen that movie because I'm not a huge fan of Harry Potter. But honestly, I think this movie is way better than Harry Potter. The Deathly Hallows from Part 2. Even I'm not a fan of Harry Potter, but thank God Fantastic Beasts made me liking Harry Potter again. So yeah, and don't worry, I will watch that movie anytime soon. But but honestly, that is not gonna be my favorite movie from 2011. This has to be this, and thank God this movie got a awarded reward. I don't understand why this movie bombed at the box office. Yep, this movie bombed at the box office, which honestly, I was completely angry that this movie bomb at the box office. And this is honestly one of the most saddest box office bomb movie of 2011. I don't understand why a lot of people went to saw the Muppet. Apparently the reason why this movie bomb at the box office is because people went to saw the Muppet. Darn you people. This is the main reason why this movie bomb, just because of the Muppet. But even I really enjoy the Muppet, but honestly, this movie is way better than the Muppet. And so yeah guys, and that's why Higo, this is honestly one of the best movie of 2011. Let's go back in 2012. Added up one of the second best year for movies. So yeah, let's go back in 2012. Alright. This is honestly one of the best closing Batman movie I've ever seen. And this is honestly one of the best written finale movie we ever got in 2012. And that movie is one of the best movies of 2012. It's had to be The Dark Knight Rises. And I know Mitchell is going to say Skyfall is one of your best movies of 2012. Which honestly, I don't understand why I don't talk about Skyfall like I used to be. Because I totally forgot about that movie. Honestly, don't get me wrong. Skyfall is an epic, brilliant masterpiece. But this movie is one of the best movies of 2012. And this has to be one of the most underrated Batman movies I've ever seen. This movie is way better than Batman 1966. Which honestly, one of the most overrated Batman I ever seen. Yes, people, I watched it. It was awful. It was so cartoony. Yeah. And so, guys, oh my goodness, it's the same thing with my school. I want to watch Mario, which honestly, I'm not going to watch that. I'm not going to rewatch that. That movie was boring. And so, guys, and Bane from Tom Hardy, this is honestly one of the second best Tom Hardy performance I've ever seen, next to him as Venom. Yup, I say it, Tom Hardy as Bane, this is honestly one of the second best performance he ever did, next to Venom, aka 80 Block. And so yeah, and Kristen Bell, honestly, he did a really good job as Batman. And Catwoman, this is honestly one of the hottest Catwoman I ever seen. Catwoman, this is honestly one of the hottest DC female characters we ever gotten. She is really hot. She is really beautiful. She is really adorable and beautiful. It's the same thing with Black Widow from the Avengers movies. And so, yeah, guys, and that's why The Dark Knight Rises, this is honestly one of the best. This is honestly one of the third best Christopher Nolan movie we ever gotten. And the second is Exception. My number one is Tenet. If you guys have a problem, Tenet is my favorite movie of 2000, from Christopher Nolan. Hey, just deal with it. There was no need to bash my opinion on Tenet. I think Tenet is really awesome, because it's you know what? Sorry, I'm itching my legs. And so, hey guys, and that's why The Dark Knight Rises, this is honestly one of the best, this is honestly one of the epic conclusion to The Dark Knight Rises. And now Morgan Freeman can do whatever he wants. That's why Kristen Bell, Tom Hardy, the actor, the voice of Catwoman in the movie, they can do whatever you want. And this is the same movie that this movie got a terrible shooting. Terrible shooting. It's from the movie theater that midnight, and that knucklehead throwing the bomb, and people run one of the wives and shooting people. This is honestly one of the most shocking thing I ever seen in 2012. who in the white mind want to go to the theater and shoot people? You don't do that. Don't do that. And I will talk about my anniversary of this movie in the video pretty soon, because this movie is turning 10 year old. Yep, this movie is turning 10 year old, folks. The same with Hotel Transylvania and Wreck-It Ralph and Skyfall and Avengers. And sorry, guys, and that's why The Dark Knight is honestly one of the best movies of 2012. And I'm going to tell you the reason why this movie is dangerous is because of that shooting. So yeah, guys, skip by in 2013. I know people is going to disagree, because I know a lot of people is going to say, "Hey, Nick, can you change your opinion on Frozen 1? Frozen 1 is way better than Man of Steel, because Frozen 1 is the most important movie from 2013. So if you guys say that, I'm not going to change my opinion on Frozen 1. Frozen 1, honestly, one of the most overrated movies of 2013. And I don't understand why. I don't understand why people say Frozen 1 is way better than Frozen 2. It makes me angry a lot of time that people said that. And sorry, guys. And that's why this movie is honestly one of the best movies of 2013. And this is honestly one of the best Zack Snyder movies that he ever directed. And this movie, we need Henry Cavill Man of Steel. We need Henry Cavill back from DCEU. There was no need to Warner Brothers to sign him out and making bullcrap movie, which is a Batwheel movie, a Batgirl movie, Wonder Twist movie, which honestly, thank God that movie got canceled, because no one in the monkey want to see a movie about Wonder Twist. I think Wonder Twist is one of the worst DC characters I ever seen, because Wonder Twist do not do nothing. Because the female one, they do great, but the male one, they do not do nothing. They're trying to do a bug of water. How the bug of water is going to be the best action from the DC? Stupid. And thank God the new CEO from Warner Brothers is canceled that movie. And yep, you take that, Tommy Emmerich and Walter Hamada. Nobody want to see a Wonder Twist movie. Sorry, guys, let's not talk about Wonder Twist. We're talking about this movie. Honestly, this is honestly one of the best Superman movies I ever seen. The story is really awesome. And Zack Snyder direction and his direction of the movie. Zack Snyder, you did a really good job, man. This is honestly one of... Yup, that's why Zack Snyder is my second favorite director I have ever seen. Because Zack Snyder is really awesome. His plan is so legendary. Because Zack Snyder know about Superman. He know about Superman. He know about Batman. He knows Wonder Woman. He know Aquaman, The Flash, Aquaman, and Cyborg. He know all the characters from the source material. At least Zack Snyder is the only director who follows the source material. But with Josh Whedon, I know he's really good at the Avengers, but after I saw Josh's read, I'm sorry, Josh, but you are now my worst director I have ever seen. I'm going to redo that video in the future. And sorry, guys, and that's my Man of Steel. This is honestly one of the best movies of 2013. This movie is way better than Frozen 1. Yep, blame on the hate comment, please. Because I know a lot of people will be angry when I said this movie is way better than Frozen 1. Hey. This is my channel. I can do what I want. I see. That's all, you guys, and that's why this movie is one of the best movies of 2013. Let's go back in 2014. All right, guys. I just going to think for a second, because after I saw my top 10 best movie of 2014, because I know Nostalgia will be my favorite movie of 2014, but I think this movie is way better. And I know in my reward in 2014, I give it to Nostalgia, but this movie deserves that reward, so yeah. And sorry, guys, one of the best movies of 2014, it had to be Beast 6. This is honestly one of the best written superhero movies that Disney ever did. And this movie is a really awesome movie. My favorite character of this movie, it's between with Ankan and Gogo, which honestly, those two female characters, it's one of the best female character crush I have ever seen in 2014. And no, people, I don't have a crush on honey women, because she kind of reminds me of Rapunzel from Tangled, because her personality, her design, work a symbol to Rapunzel from Tangled. Yep, you can put it on a hate comment when I say that. And sorry, guys, and honestly, I don't mind the twist villain, because I don't understand why people call it one of the worst twist villains. So are you telling me that this twist villain is even worse? than the Hans Twist villain for Frozen 1? No! I think the Hans Twist villain is like Prince Charming from Disney. This is really like a Disney version of Prince Charming from Shrek the Third. Even I freaking hate Prince Charming and Shrek the Third. So yeah. Sorry, guys. In the animation, I really like the animation. The animation is really good to look at. And this is honestly one of the best looking Disney of 2014. This is honestly one of the best movie of 2014. Let's go back in 2015. Well, originally, The Kingsman: The Secret Service added one of the best movie of 2015. But after I think about Skyfall, Spectre, this movie deserved to be on the list. So yeah, guys. One of the best movies of 2015, it had to be Spectre. Honestly, this is honestly one of the second best Bond movie I have ever seen. Yes, people, it's way better than Skyfall, Casino Royale, and Quantum of Solace. Even No Time to Die is either one of the best Bond movie I ever seen. We're gonna get to that in a minute. And this movie is a really awesome Bond movie. The story is really good, the character is so good, and Daniel Craig, you once again added one of your best Bond I have ever seen, and I will, because I really hope Henry Cavill will be a new Bond, not The Rock, because I don't need The Rock as Bond. I know I saw him in Red Notice, but come on, we don't need The Rock as Bond. It's even worth saying he was cast at Aladdin for Aladdin 2, doing to Will Smith smacking Chris Rock. I don't want to talk about that. It's stupid. Sorry, guys. In the action, oh my goodness, the action is so amazing. And the villain of this movie, this is honestly one of the second best villain of 2015, because this villain, what did I just say? But the villain of this movie, this is honestly one of the second Bond of, this is honestly one of the second favorite Bond villain that Bond and all the MGM ever did. And I know this movie owned by 20th Century Studio, which honestly I don't care, because this movie owned by Universal now, so yeah. And so you guys, and that's why Spectre is honestly one of the best movies of 2015. Even 2016 is one of the most crappy year that we ever did. Like, come on, we have a trailer bash crash for Ghostbuster. We have Willy Wonka passed away. We have Princess Air passed away. We had Donald Trump become the president. And this is honestly one of the best president movie I've ever seen. Reason why, if you haven't seen the movie, how about you check it out? It's on Disney Plus. Pretty awesome. And so, guys, one of the best movies of 2016 has to be Zootopia. But which means Wild Lands was my favorite movie of 2016. Which honestly, Frozen say I gotta put this movie back in my best movie of 2016. Reason why? Because Movie Dude, which is a really great user, because I still have to feel false about him. But he keep praising Wild Lands like they're better than God. Oh, Wild Lands is a really awesome movie for Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone. Come on, people. Come on. You can't play Wild Lands. Better than God. Come on, please. And so, hey guys, and the animation is a really awesome animation. And Judy Hopp, she's a really cute little bunny rabbit. And I really want to hug her like a teddy bear. Aww. And Nick Wah, no, not me, because I was the kid when this movie came out. And this movie is a really awesome president movie. And this movie based on the true story, because we all know about the story of the president, of the government, and etc. And thank God Disney took that story and made it to the movie. And this is honestly one of the best politic movie I've ever seen. And that's why this movie is one of the best movie of 2016. So you could request me to do So if you want me to redo my Toon Style or my Zootopia, because that Toon Style I made last year did not age well, because that Toon Style was god awful. So you can request me. You can want me to do a redo Toon Style today or tomorrow. Hey, you can let me know. You can let me know in the comment section. So yeah, and that's why Zootopia is added on one of the best politics movie I've ever seen. This is honestly one of the second best Disney movie I've ever seen, next to Frozen 2. Yeah. And this is honestly one of the best movie of 2016. And this movie is way better than Polar Crap. 2017. Oh boy, let's get back to 2017. 2017 is one of the worst years for animation, just like in 2013. But no other movie would be great, because I know Logan and etc. was one of your best movie of 2017. I don't understand why people say A Shape of Water is your best movie of 2017. Are you crazy, people? Are you crazy? And honestly, I had to choose this movie. Every time I think about the movie, and a lot of time I really so excited about this series coming on Amazon. I'm not watching the Adult Swim version of Blade Runner. It looks god awful with the god awful animation. And so, you guys, and that's why Blade Runner is my favorite movie of 2017. The story, the special effect, the villain, anything Manzi in the movie, and the whole photo in the movie, Ryan Gosling in the movie. Jared Leto as a villain is a really awesome villain, and this has to be one of the best performances that he ever did. Yep, he's way better as a Joker and as Morbius. Yeah, this is way better than Morbius. Reason why? Because Jared Leto was in that movie as well. I am so ready to watch that movie. And sorry, guys, and that's why Blade Runner 2049. This is honestly one of the best movies of 2017, and I highly recommend you watch it. Alright, 2018. Oh boy, let's get back to 2018. 2018 is one of the okay year for movies, and I know we got The Happy Time Murders, Wreck-It Ralph 2, which honestly, those two movies, I don't want to talk about it, is crap. And so, hey guys, and I don't know, one of the best movie of 2018. It had to be Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. I'm kind of ashamed that the Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse part 2, part 1 got delayed due to no reason. Really, Sony? Who in the white mind wanted to wait up for no reason? Oh, come on, people. Gwen Stacy was in 2022. Calendar, darn it. Oh well. At least my 2022 movie will be an improvement. And this movie is a really awesome Quentin multiverse movie. And this is a great start to the Spider-Man multiverse movie. The story is really good. I really like the multiverse story. Because all the Spider-Man decade characters, like the anime Spider-Man, the black and white Spider-Man voiced by Nicolas Cage. Yep, Nick Cage is in the movie. He's way better than Nick Cage was in the movie as Superman. And the cartoon Spider-Man, Peter B. Parker Spider-Man, the black Spider-Man, And in a really Harry Steinfeld version of a Spider-Man. Yep, she's Spider-Gwen. Yep, she's really Spider-Gwen. Really hope she could be in a live action. Who in live action? Kevin Feige, please hire Harry Steinfeld as Gwen Stacy. And probably Emma Stone don't want to be Gwen Stacy because she's busy with Cruella. But just hire Harry Steinfeld because I really want to see Harry Steinfeld wearing that Spider-Gwen costume. That would be pretty awesome. This is honestly one of the best second best performances that Harry Steinfeld ever did, next to Kate from Hawkeye show, which honestly I don't understand why people hate that show for no reason. And so that's right, guys, and that's why any animation, this has to be one of the best working animation I ever seen for Sony Picture Animation, and this is honestly one of the best movies of 2018. Alright, let's go back in 2019. I don't know, one of the best year for movies. And I know 2019 has some crazy crap, like the Game of Thrones selling whole bathwater, and people fighting at Disneyland, people planning to storm Area 51, which honestly, that has to be one of the dumbest things that people ever did. Who in the right mind wanted to storm Area 51? That is stupid. And I know we got crappy movies like Heck Boy, The Good Boy, which honestly, I think Good Boy is a bit overrated. I don't understand why people like that movie. Hey guys, don't get me wrong. I like comedy movie, but Good Boy is not my comedy. It is not my kind of comedy movie I would watch for 2,000 times, stupid. And so, hey guys, and I know people are going to say Knife Alley is your best movie, or Joker is your best movie, or The Avengers Endgame is your best movie, but no other movie will be the best movie of 2018 is Frozen 2. Yep, Frozen 2. This is honestly one of the best Disney movies we ever seen, and this movie is honestly one of the best Jennifer Lee and Chris Buck movie I have ever seen in my entire life. The story is so original, the character is so unforgettable, the story, let's just talk about the story. Alright, we'll try it again. The story is so original, the character is so great, and Anna and Elsa, this is honestly one of the best Disney princess characters that we ever seen in a lifetime. Elsa, she's really my favorite female crush character I ever seen. She is really such a beauty. Yeah, look at her eyes. Is she look like a beauty? She Is she look like a beauty?
She is really beauty.
Yeah.
And in Anna, this is honestly one of the best Christian Bale characters that she ever did. No, not Christian Bale from Dark Knight. No, I'm talking about Christian Bale from The Good Place and Frozen 2. And Christian Bale will always be Anna. Not Anna Kendrick in the troll movies. I don't want her to be as Anna. And I know her name starting with Anna. Like, come on, people. Who want to see Poppy as the Anna? No one wants to see that. That would be disgusting. Man, people made me disgusted. And sorry, guys. And Kristoff is a really awesome character. And this is honestly one of the best Jonathan Groff character that he ever did. The same thing. He was in the villain from The Matrix Resurrection, which is really awesome too. I've never seen him smoking before. Sorry about the guys. And sorry guys. And Olaf, I don't understand why people keep saying Olaf is Jar Jar of Disney. So whoever say is the Jar Jar of Disney, I'll probably you all smoking a choking quad pod. I highly recommend you put that down and stop saying that. But I think Olaf is a really awesome character. He's a really hilarious character. Every time I rewatch this movie, and a lot of the time, I really want to be in a Enchanted Forest. And this movie is honestly one of the best written Disney movie that we ever did. This is honestly like the Lord of the Rings of Frozen. That's why this is really a Disney version of the Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit trilogy. Reason why? Because this movie set up for an awesome trilogy. So let's hope Frozen 3 will be the best trilogy that we ever did. So let's hope Frozen 3 will be an epic conclusion to the Frozen franchise. So I really hope this movie will become a trilogy. If it becomes a trilogy, I will say one of the best trilogies that we ever did. And Frozen 2 will be the huge part of my heart, because we'll never forget all the adventures of Anna and Elsa, Olaf, Sin, and Kristoff go on an Enchanted Forest to find the boys. We never see that type of story. Because we need more anime movie, more mature, like this movie right there. So if you people said this movie is for babies, I'll probably you're smoking, charging, crying, but I recommend you put that down. But this movie is the best written Frozen movie that we ever did. So, yeah. So that's why Frozen 2, this is honestly one of the best Disney movie we ever seen. This movie's way better than Artemis Turd. Artemis Fowl, but like Artemis Turd. I don't want to think about that movie. I would do a rant of the movie anniversary, and I would do a cringe cinema on my live stream on Instagram, so stay tuned for that on YouTube anyway. And so that's right, guys, and that's why Frozen 2 is added out one of the best movie of 2019, and this movie is a great end to the 2010 decade. So yeah, let's go back into 2020. So yeah, let's go back to 2020. Well, even 2020, this is honestly one of the worst shows that we ever experienced. Like, come on, we have the Caribbean thing, we have the COVID, we have the Black Lives Matter hashtag, we have George Floyd controversy of that, and we have so many movie delay, like No Time to Die delay, Black Widow delay, Tenet delay, and etc. But no other movie will be one of the best movie of 2020, and thank God this movie saved 2020. You know what movie is that? Well, the movie is another Christopher Nolan movie called Tenet. Yep, starring George David Washington and Robert Pattinson, which is a really awesome actor. And sorry, guys, the story is really awesome. The character is so amazing. One of the best action of the movie. It had to be the car chase. The car chase, this is honestly one of the best scenes of the movie. And the villain of this movie, it played by the same actor. He was in The Death and the Nile as a detective character. He's in the villain of this movie. This is honestly one of the best villains of 2020. I know a lot of people would say Soul is your best movie of 2020, which honestly, I think this movie is way better than Soul, in my opinion. And sorry, guys, this movie is way better than Cutie, which honestly, I'm not going to show a picture of it, I'm not going to watch a trailer of it, I'm not going to watch a movie of it. And yes, people, I watched the few scenes on YouTube. It was cringy. It was cringing, it was stupid, it was disgusting, it makes me want to vomit. And sorry, guys, and that's why Tenet is added up one of the best scenes of 2020. Oh, okay. Let's make this quick, because I know this video is going to be the 1-hour video. I don't want to do that. I don't want to be like Mighty Puff Fanboy. Alright, guys. Let's go back in 2021. Alright. No Edo finale movie, but The Lord of the Rings, Return of the King, and The Avengers Endgame has some really epic conclusion. But no other epic conclusion. This is the main reason why this movie called Nick Hick and Frozen 2 and No to Die Fan 2001. This is the main reason why this movie was a huge part of my heart. And this is honestly one of the second best movies that we ever did in our lifetime. And whoever directed this, they deserve a really good reward. They deserve like a medal right there. Because this movie is important. This movie is the second most rewatched, because every time I rewatch this movie, and a lot of the time I really love this movie to death. But you know what movie is that? The best movie of 2021, it has to be No Time to Die. This is honestly one of the best Dana Quaid movie I've ever seen. This movie is added one of the best Universal movie I've ever seen. Yes, people, Bond owned by Universal. But this is, has to be one of the second favorite movie I have ever seen in my life. Whoever hates this movie, I'm probably you all smoking inside out into the one crock pot. I highly recommend you put that down and watch this movie. And sorry guys, and one of the best characters of this movie, it's had to be anything to Mon-Z character. She is a really awesome character. This is honestly one of the best character of 2021. This is honestly one of my favorite female crush character of 2021. And I know she is in Deep Water and in Knife Out, which honestly I don't give a flying monkey that she's in the Wet It All movie, because I'm 20 year old and I can do what I want. Because I'm gonna be 21, I'm gonna be 22. Don't treat me, I am a 3-year-old, stupid. And sorry guys, and Dana Quaid, you did a really awesome performance. And this is the main reason why you are the best Bond characters. But and Seven, this is honestly one of the best villain I ever seen for James Bond, because Seven is a really creepy guy, and I know he's the voice of the same actor. He was the voice of the Queen movie, which honestly, haven't seen the movie. I bought a DVD a bit. I'm probably gonna watch it after I watch the War of the World movie from Tom Cruise anyway. And sorry guys, one of the saddest moment I've ever seen. If you don't want me to hear a spoiler, I recommend you skip it. But there was a scene when Bond say, "I know," and then and you see the flying of the sky, and he say, "I know," and boom, an explosion, and the sad music, and all the characters from the movie, like Ralph Virgil and Dana Quaid's wife, in this movie, she was really upset, and a lot of characters really upset too. This has to be one of the most saddest death scene I ever seen in the movie history. The same thing with Elsa death scene and Mufasa death scene. But all the death scene I know, like the Hobbit death scene and the Lion King death scene and Frozen 2 death scene. But this is the only death scene I actually cry. It's kind of shame that I cry over Elsa death scene for Frozen 2. How I didn't cry that scene. Because this scene, this is honestly one of the most saddest scene I have ever seen from MGM. So whoever directed this, you did a really good job to direct this. Because without this movie, we won't have any crappy action movie. Because this movie, this is the reason why I got back liking action movies. Because after the disaster of all the Bruce Willis action movie, a Reminiscem action movie, those two action movies from the actor, he was so good back in the day, but now it sucks. He just made action movies, but terrible. But after this movie, thank you, Dana Quaid, for letting me like this movie. But all the crew who made this movie, and that No Time to Die song, this is honestly one of the best Bond songs I have ever seen. And Billy Usher, you did a really good job to sing that song. This is honestly one of the longest songs I ever seen for a Bond movie, so yeah. And sorry guys, in Universal, the director and the crew, if you're watching this, thank you so much for making this movie. And thank you so much for making this as an epic and a final conclusion. And this is honestly one of the best finale movie I have ever seen. This movie is way better than Hotel Transylvania 4. F that movie, because that movie is honestly one of the worst epic conclusion movie I've ever seen. That movie's stupid. And so, hey guys, and that's why No Time to Die added up one of the best 2021 movie I have ever seen in 2021. This is honestly one of the best movie of 2022. Now let's go back to now. Alright guys, we write the multiverse story. I don't understand why a lot of people think this movie is crap. I don't understand why people say Chip and Dale movie is way better than this movie. So whoever say Chip and Dale movie is way better than this movie, I'm probably you are smoking a charge and cry by because I recommend you put that down. And sorry guys, I am no problem that Wanda is a villain. I am no problem this movie has a disappointing cameo with because we all know Professor X is going to be in the movie because he was in the trailer, stupid. And sorry guys, one of the best movie of 2022. Even I cannot watch The Watchmen. Even I cannot watch The Northman because I'm living in a family-friendly house. But one of the best movie of 2022, it has to be Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. This is honestly one of the best written multiverse storyline that we ever gotten. And this movie is honestly one of the second best Marvel movie that we ever did. Wanda, she is top there with Thanos out of one of the best MCU villain that she ever did. OMG, this is honestly one of the best horror movie I have ever seen. Hey Freeman, if you're not a fan of the horror movie, this movie will be changing of your life. This movie is creepy, it's disturbing, it's awesome, it's amazing, it's really awesome MCU movie. And even I like the movie, but Spider-Man No Way Home will always be my favorite movie of 2020 from the MCU. But that's why Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, this is honestly one of the best movies of 2022. And sorry guys, that was my video on my best movie from every year I was alive. I know this video is a little longer video, which honestly I have no problem with doing longer video. You know what? Let me see what the runtime is. 15 minutes. Okay. And sorry guys, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button, notification, show this family, and stay tuned for the worst movie from every year I was alive. Oh boy, Artemis Fowl, Freddy Got Fingers, Cinderella is coming back into my channel, which honestly, not excited about that. And sorry guys, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button, turn the notification, share this video with your family, and I see you next time. So long, peace YouTube, and I see you guys my next video right now, and I see you guys next time.